I saw it. What's up, guys? Zero here, and welcome back to Deathmark. Now, last time, we just got into chapter 3, and we're dealing with yet another ghost. This one happens to deal with, apparently, phones. Well, phone booths. So, there's three locations that we have to investigate. Well, one of them we've already saw at the previous episode was the highway. The other two, one's in the mountains and one's in the city next to an apartment complex. So let's go ahead and head to the first, well, technically the second phone booth. Well, all we can do is wait. No, I wasn't. I wasn't expecting you to do anything. I'll be fine. Young woman kidnapped. Five years ago. Okay. I ain't see shit. No. What do you want to see? Lord Buddha. the fuck do you know about my mark? Okay. That fucking happened. I think I might have went. No, I can still hear. All we can do is check the other phone booth at this point. Let's just say she wasn't happy with my question. Maybe. Yeah, let's head back. Maybe it would be best to compare notes with Mary. More like borderline psychotic is the more accurate term. Question is, what else should we ask? All right, now to head to the rest area. I'm guessing it's your turn. Where did I go wrong? wrong question, or more or less did she just not want to answer? Don't adhere to the gossip. Defy it. Rumors. Okay. Go back to the car. Yeah, I think I might have an idea. And if shit goes wrong, well, we're all fucked. Okay. What is it? Don't talk about eyes or things like it when you're on the phone with Hanayome. Don't say I. This is it? She must be blind. Or lost her eyesight. Five years ago. At this point, there's no such thing as coincidence. Nope. Shit. Okay. Looks like I don't have much of a choice at this point. Have to say it. I have no fucking tools. Yeah, stay there. Don't say I or anything that sounds like it. I have to defy it. I have to say, I. I saw it. Whoa. Telescope. Maybe pink. My dreams. Shit, that's wrong. Oh, fuck. It could have been better. Psycho, I'll dispel all of your heartache, so forget that horrible incident and take your quiet rest up in heaven. An incident? What? You know something, and you're not letting me in. Yeah. What about him? Hard to say, honestly. We need to find whatever we can on what happened 5 years ago, if we want to have any idea on what kind of spirit we're dealing with. That's why she had criminal cases. Correct? Really? The victim's name is Psycho. February, 5 years ago. I guarantee you it's February the 8th, is it not? Psycho Hesegawa. Suicide in the forest on the eve of her wedding. Wow. Not something a child should be reading. Really? Yeah, what can you tell us about this story? I guarantee you that gang was the Yakuza. Oh my God. What? Wow. Yeah, is that true? You've got to be fucking kidding me. Fucking horrible is what it is. And Hanayome, I'm starting to think that she is Hanayome. Psycho could be Hanayome. I mean, everything's starting to line up, so it makes perfect sense. She was abducted by the park, assaulted in the rest area. And her dog was killed off the highway. Hanayome and Psycho Hasegawa are one and the same. It's possible. Yeah, that is strange. She wanted us to find it, is what I think. Yeah, where's the fiance now? Don't tell me. Really? So everyone that was involved, whether it was the fiance or the people who attacked her, just went up missing. Right, nothing solid. Hmm. those pictures are probably of the assault. I swear, this shit makes my stomach turn. Yeah. She was at her most vulnerable moment. She didn't want to be seen like that. No one would. It would, yeah, it wouldn't happen to be H for us, would it? Okay. Yeah. We gotta find whatever we can about Hanayome. So we have to go where she passed away. Well, guys, unfortunately, that's all the time we have for today, but when we come back, we're headed to the forest to continue our investigation on Hanayome. And if I may say something before I end this video, this video plus the entire forest section, it has been kind of heavy for me, because one thing I know, I can't really understand what some people are going through, whether it be depression or anything like that, but if you're going through something like that, seek any kind of assurance from someone. Like, get help, because suicide is never the answer. And I know I'm not really much of one to actually speak on this because it's kind of a heavy subject, but I feel it's right for me to say something about this. It's suicide is never the answer. Always, there's always places that you can go to talk about this. There's, I'm pretty sure there's counseling, there's anything to get not really information, but more or less someone who can help you through the pain that you're going through. And that's all the time I have for today, guys. And until then, this is Zero, and I'll see you guys in the next video.